Hello everyone, how y'all doing? Welcome back to the Ickyverse. I'm glad to have you here, glad to be here reviewing some propellers for you guys. These are the brand stinking new Gemfan Hurricane props for your racing drone. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about them, we're gonna review them, we're gonna test them, and make some comparisons to a few different brands as well. Stick around to the end to hear my opinion between the HQ, the Dow prop, and Gemfan, because I have been flying all of them for a while, and I've got some insight. So we're gonna listen and we're gonna talk a little bit about that. But right now, we're gonna talk about the Hurricanes. For the sake of simplicity, I'm gonna be calling this the Hurricane V2. These are the Hurricane V1s because we're gonna make them a few comparisons. No, they are not related in any way except for the fact that they're made by Gemfan and they have the Hurricane label, but these are for racing. These are more of a multi-purpose propeller, freestyle, racing, whatever you want. These are very purpose-built and they're amazing at what they do. Are you going to be able to get away with a little bit of freestyle, maybe some long range with these propellers? Yes, I think so, and we're going to talk about why. But this is here, the Hurricane V1s are going to be the 51x49.9 propellers, almost a 5150, not quite there. These, the V2s, these are going to be a 51x46.6, almost a 51x47, but not quite. And they're very, very awesome. So let's talk a little bit about why they are so awesome right off the bat. So they're skinny props. Dow props came out with a propeller, a 5150, I believe. Let me go grab it for you. So these are the 5150s. Unfortunately, this isn't the greatest color, but they're very skinny prop. And it kind of hit the market and everybody was like, whoa, that's nice. What's it gonna do? Well, it's gonna spool up really quickly. It's very light for the pitch that it's got, which was kind of an advancement and something new to the market, but it didn't really catch on that great. People were like, oh yeah, it's great. They bought them up, used them, and were like, eh. For the pitch that it had, it just didn't have the stiffness that it needed, and it kind of stalled out. It's like, yeah, it can spool up really quick, but once you really put a load on it and get in those corners, it lacked something that we needed for the performance. This is not an answer to that propeller. This is an answer to racing. So it is a very thin propeller. It's light, it spools up very quickly. Use them on your high KV motors. Use them on a medium KV with a high cell rate, 5 or 6S, and you're really gonna see some success. I used them on some 5S and some 4S mini quads and I really liked it. So one, tick the box. Boom, it's thin and it's light. It spools up quickly. That's a plus. While it's doing that, there is a very specific hump, what we're gonna call it, near the hub of this propeller. So today I'm gonna be the makeshift prop scientist. Right here on the midsection of the propeller, after the hub section, there is a nice little hump. You've seen a little bit of this on the older Gemfans, just not as pronounced, but the Dow prop 5146 is the first propeller that I saw had this. What that seems to do is it seems to give you a little more pep at the bottom end, but the design of this hump and how you design the leading edge, which is gonna be this portion here, this portion that hits the air first, how you design that, the scoop down into the hump and how it reacts to the air and sends it across the rest of the propeller, makes a really big difference. And I think looking at this prop compared to, let's compare it to the V1 Hurricanes, because these are very similar props in that they both have a hump and they're both propellers. That's about all the comparisons we can make here. The leading edge on the Hurricane V1s is a very straight leading edge. It hits the air and it sends it to the rest of the prop. That's it. Leading edge on the V2s has a very pronounced visual hump that you see similar to an HQ V1S. And what that does is it's gonna give you a little bit of pep at the beginning and then taper it off once it hits that hump and it makes it very predictable. So the hump right here, the little scoop we're gonna call it at the leading edge of the propeller, will take that air and it looks like this, right? And you got the rest of the prop evens out. That scoop is gonna scoop the air, brings it straight in and then leads it straight to the hump and a V. So it's sending it straight there and it really forces that stuff right there. Boom, it gives you that pep that you need and then you're good to go. What I like about this propeller is that it has the hump and then it just kind of tails off to the end of the propeller and then the rest of this shape is designed to take advantage of that particular bit of air there and then spread it around, make sure the propeller gets everything that it needs, and then magic happens. So if we're looking at the leading edge of both of these propellers, the V1 Hurricane, the V2, the V1 is a very sweeping curve around this area here, and the V2 is a very straight curve until it gets just to the end, starts to taper off. Let's talk a little bit about why this is such a good racing propeller. Just plain and simple, it is peppy, it's snappy on the low end, but when you get to the mid to the top throttle ranges, it's still there. And I think that has a lot to do with having the scoop on the leading edge. It's actually a very large scoop. It's a larger scoop than what you see on the HQV1Ss. The dowel props are completely missing it entirely. And then the hump that it leads to is very pronounced, but just the taper that they lead off to the end of this propeller, it works very well. And then everything spools up so fast because it's a light propeller, but they left enough meat on the end of it compared to the old gym, the dowel prop 5150s or whatever they're called. It just kind of went propeller and then nothing. So you're not taking advantage of all the air that you've got on the end of these propellers at high speeds. It's all here. Everything is there. It's all here in this propeller, and it's amazing. But to top it all off, it's not just the snappiest, coolest, lightest frickin' spooling up propeller that I've ever had and seen or used. It's also super duper smooth. It's got some flex in it where it needs it. And I noticed with, you know, not a poorly tuned quad, but not a very well tuned quad, when I threw these on there and I expected some crazy oscillations and some bounce back from that mini quad, when I started hitting these corners real fast and doing all these, just going into dirty air and everything, I didn't get any of that, which was surprising. And I started to realize it, like, it gave me my cake and let me eat it too. I mean, that's the best analogy I can come up with, guys, because I could snap around a corner, snap right back, and then, I mean, I could like do a dead stop, I could pop out of something, I could do anything, and it just took it all and just kept eating and going, and I love it. And there's something about it, you just need to try it, stick it on your mini quad, stick it on any motor you got, whatever KV, whatever battery size and cell size you got, try them out. I'm telling you, there's just this very particular dance between snappiness and smoothness that they really figured out on this thing, and it's awesome, and I haven't felt it with anything else. And I will say this, I really like the Gemfan flash props. Super duper snappy, but smooth. This is an entirely different design, and it's better, and I don't know how they did it. So peppy, like, God dang, man, like, oh, dude, I was not expecting it. Like, I knew they were gonna be poppy, a little bit low end, a little playfulness, and smooth, but these things are like impossibly snappy and smooth at the same time. I can't figure that out. So props to you, Gemfan. You really, really surprised the heck out of me with that one. You know what, I want to talk about why I like Gemfan so much, because if you guys haven't tried them yet, yes, you should. Because, see, I've got here some HQs and some dowel props. I went back and forth between these two propellers for the longest time until I found Gemfan and realized that Gemfan are always at the front. They're always trying new and different things that these other companies just aren't really trying to do. HQ kept coming out with the same propeller with like a slightly different pitch. And like, that was it. And I got tired of it, you know? They keep coming up, well, I keep buying them, keep eating them up, and then nothing was changing.